Okay, today we're going to draw an old man's face. Let's start by making a rectangle in perspective. That's right, let's see what we can do just to start carving in some simple shapes and then make a face from that. All right, let's get a rectangle shape going here and start to structure in a head and face. So once again, horizon line, couple of vanishing points, and if you can create something in perspective with a rectangle, you can create anything. So let's see what we can do here. Hit the vanishing points, make a box shape here, and start to get some structure in. The reason that you hit vanishing points is to try to get some structure and perspective for the volumes that you're going to create. You don't want to have flat drawings all the time, so you want to get some volume into the drawings. So let's see, we get a couple of vanishing points, and we start to carve in a simple, primitive shape here, just a simple rectangle shape, hit those vanishing points, and start to line things up. Of course, it's not going to be a square head character, but you're going to start with a rectangle shape. Then you can subdivide, and then you can start to carve in some circle shapes within this rectangle shape. Okay, let's get a center line going down here and dissect the corners here from one corner to another. And the same on this side, dissect the corners and down the center. And that's how we're going to get some circle shapes to hit these points. So you want to do what you can to dissect as many points as you can, and then that way you've got some lines that you can hit when you freehand the circle shapes. Okay, use a rough loose pencil here, thick pencil, just to start carving in the shapes here. Block in some shapes and try to think what you want. The most important thing is to be creative. Try to get some circle shapes mixed here and start to block in now where we're going to put some eyes. So let's see what we can do just to start mapping in a nose and eyes here, get it centered in and see what we can do. All right, let's start to mark in where the eyes are going to be, where the nose is going to be, just simple block shapes in the beginning, just mapping everything and try to start getting some structure into the rectangle shape. So let's hit the vanishing points and try to get some volume to this drawing and just start to work some curves that are going to be in. So we're working on a chin here. Get something going around and see what we can do to create this drawing. Okay, we'd start to draw in the eye and the eyebrow here, and then between that, it's approximately one eye between the two eyes that are centered, and we get the nose structured in and try to get some shapes going. So this way we don't get the drawing too flat and we can start to structure in some of the volumes. Let's see what we can do. Get the eyebrow going over the top here and some of the underneath lines that'll happen for the face. And start to use the loose pencil here to carve everything in. Get a feel around the eye and the cheek here and see what we can do. Structure over the top. There we go. So we can do a few hairs over the top here. Get some of the skull going in and start to map things over the back and get some hair hanging in there. And just keep things loose. Block in the shapes first and see if you like them and go from there. So, you know, we hit the vanishing points, we hit the blocks in there, we got the eyes in, and start to get the face, the shape of the head going. See what we can do for the ear here, and start to map that one in, which starts from the top of the eye down to the mouth, and carve it in here. Once again, you can draw a rectangle, you can draw anything, you can dissect the corners of the rectangle, put a center points in and make a circle, and that can become a round object. And then you start to structure in all of the rest of the creative elements of the drawing. So let's see what we can do. Start to get some of the lines going underneath here and start to draw in the mouth shape. Just very simple. First, simple lines. Just block in some mouth shapes and the chin and see what we can do just to block in and carve some of the shapes around now and then down into the neck and into some of the structure that's here. We're starting to get some life into the drawing. You can see it happening. And start to work over these rough shapes here. Get some details into the neck area here. And yeah, there we go. We're starting to see some life here. All right, let's get another pencil going now and start to get into the eye. We want to exaggerate the iris of the eye. That's a very important element because when you take a photo of an eye, you'll just see like a dot in the center. So we want to exaggerate the iris of the eye and we want to get some direction where the character is looking.